Hi. In this short video, we're going to take a look around the Add-ons Ultimate backend. Add-ons Ultimate allows you to add extra fields and options to your WooCommerce products. You can add these fields in two places, globally or per product. Per product means you add fields to individual products. From your product edit screen, click on Product Add-ons in the Product Data section. You can see that the plugin is totally integrated with WordPress and WooCommerce. Unlike some plugins which implement their own obtrusive styles, which often clash with the rest of the WP dashboard, there is no new interface. Add-ons Ultimate forms part of the standard flow of the admin and should be familiar to anyone who uses WordPress. Start by adding a new group, which is a collection of fields, then a new field. You can enter a label for the field, choose the field type, and assign a price. Depending on the type of field, you might be able to add some extra options, for radio buttons or select fields, for example. Each option can also have its own price assigned, so if the user chooses an option, the corresponding price will be added to the product total. There are many other settings. You can ensure that the field is required, or you can set the price to flat rate, and so on. You can also set conditions on each field, so the field will only display if certain parameters have been met. It's easy to add conditions, either on fields or groups. You can also specify that fields should be variation specific, so they'll only display when certain variations are chosen. You can change the order of fields within groups by dragging and dropping. You can also change the order of groups. If you want to duplicate a field or group, it's easy to do so. And of course, you can delete unwanted groups and fields if you wish. You have all the same options when adding fields globally, except that here you can create a field once and apply it to multiple products. Either all products, to multiple products, or by category. There are also a number of settings that change the plugin behavior. Again, these are just on a standard WooCommerce settings page, organized logically according to functionality. When you receive orders containing products with add-ons, the add-ons are listed as part of the standard order screen. Add-ons are stored as standard WooCommerce metadata, so will be compatible with any third-party plugins you're using, for example, for invoicing or packing lists. You also see the add-ons listed in standard WooCommerce admin emails, and customers will also receive them in their confirmation emails. There's extensive documentation for the plugin, as well as a number of helpful videos. Documentation can be accessed from directly in the plugin, and of course, you have access to our support team. For more information, check out the resources section on the Plugin Republic website, where you'll find dozens of tutorials and case studies. Thanks for watching, and make sure you hit the like and subscribe buttons.